Hello guys, welcome back to Home Theater Enthusiast. This is my first video in 2021. Wish you all a very happy new year. First of all, sorry for a month gap for uploading videos in my channel. I was in a process of upgrading my home theater setup. The work is almost complete. It is 11 channel Atmos theater with 7.1.4 configuration. Most of my equipments already got upgraded. I'm very excited to announce that my subwoofer center channel upgraded to SVS. The SVS SB16 Ultra, the giant 16-inch subwoofer, will be powering the bass. The SVS Ultra Center for the center channel, and the four Atmos channels will be driven by SVS Prime Elevation speakers with four Wavdale WHDFS bipole surround speakers for the surrounds. So guys, stay tuned to my channel for the unboxing and reviews of these equipments. Not only the AV equipment upgrade, I also did some decent acoustic treatment to my home theater room. In this video, I will be describing the acoustic treatments I did for the home theater. I partitioned my living room at the backside to make it closed and also to give the complete theater ambience and audio visual improvements. So today I will be explaining everything about how I converted my living room to a home theater, even though there are lots of restrictions. I'm sure this video will be helpful for those who wanted to do acoustics to their home theater in a budget-friendly manner. But I will suggest everyone should do at least a minimum level of acoustic treatment to their home theater room so that you will get better audio quality. Because this will drastically increase the clarity of the audio by reducing the reflections, and you will get the maximum performance out of your equipments. So let's get to it. Before that, if you are interested in home theater builds, audio video component reviews like speakers, streaming devices, projectors, etc., subscribe to my channel and like the video if you actually like it. Okay, so I was using my first floor living room for my home theater. It has a size of 10 by 14 feet, almost 140 square feet, because there are some uneven shape at the backside. Also, there are lots of issues which impact the audio quality, like the open room, the fan noise because of no AC, unwanted windows, smooth walls and floor, which increase the reflections, etc. There are multiple things I have to do here. The backside partition, with sound absorbing materials, ceiling acoustics, floor carpeting, sidewall acoustics. We don't need to do 100% acoustic treatment to our home theater. It will make the sound complete dumb. So be careful while doing the acoustics. A 60% acoustic treatment is more than enough for your home theater. I talked with some teams who does these home theater works, but those were very expensive for me. So I plan to do things my own with the help of appropriate laborers. I gave the ceiling and backside partition to some local interior working contractors. I gave them the design and my expectations. And I told them to use 100 GSM polyfiber foam for acoustics in the ceiling and for the backside partition. They arranged it and did the work decently. I closed my single door window with gypsum board filled with the same 100 GSM polyfiber foam. I used the perforated sheet for the ceiling and for the backside partition because they have better acoustic properties. Now remaining was the floor carpets and the acoustic panels. Floor carpet became easier because I got a decent team who does this cleanly and budget friendly. Since it was decently priced, I asked them to fix the carpets on some of my doors as well. So they did it for two new doors and one existing doors. Okay, now the only thing remaining was the acoustic panels. Since my room has lots of doors and cuts, I have two custom made acoustic panels. So I measured the size for the panels and asked my carpenters to make some frames using marine plywood. I bought the fabric and one full roll of polyfiber foam. There is three major tasks to build an acoustic panel. So first one will be measure the polyfiber foam thickness. Mine was around 5 cm. Then make the frame thickness to 4.5 cm. A 0.5 cm lesser than the polyfiber foam. So that the panel looks stiff and tight. After building the frame, fill the frame with polyfiber foam and wrap it with normal cotton fabric. It will be better to wrap both sides for a good finish. Now wrap the front side with the jute fabric. You can use stapler guns to fix the fabric tightly on the frame. Now you can hang the panels on the wall. For hanging the panels, you can fix some hooks or L-clamps on the frames. So all these panel steps completed in a day, and totally the work completed by 5 days. Including the fixing of panels as well. So if you guys have a tight budget and you want to do proper acoustics to your home theater, I will give you an estimate with which you can complete your work if you are doing it your own. Please note that the cost mentioned will be in Indian rupees. Different countries may have different charges for the labors and materials. But if you know the material and labor cost, you can calculate the minimum budget needed for your each work. So for the total ceiling acoustics, you may end up with 20 to 25k. For floor carpet, a 10k for the full acoustic carpet with foam underlay. And the wall acoustic panels will be in a range of 15 to 20k. Don't go for a lot of panels, you may need only a 30% panels on the wall depending on your room. So thank you guys, see you in the next video. I will hopefully come with a home theater tour to explain about the equipments I am using. Hope you enjoy the video. For any queries or suggestions, please comment below. And for more such videos, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you and see you in the next video.